This is the SAP Developer News for August 21st, 2025.
Hello, ABAP developers. You might have already been aware of the ABAP Extensibility Guide, which gives the overview of ABAP Cloud Development Model and ABAP-based extensibility options for both SAP S/4HANA in the cloud and on-premise. The key concept of extensibility outlined in this guide is the three-tier extensibility model. This model describes how ABAP Cloud and Classic ABAP can coexist within a same system. The new Clean Code Extensibility White Paper introduced by SAP incorporates evolution of the current three-tier extensibility model to the Clean Code level concept. The new maturity model categorizes extensions into four distinct levels, A, B, C, and D, based on the architecture integrity, upgrade safety, and alignment with Clean Code principles. Now, each extension is evaluated using a standardized methodology that looks at how the extension is built, how well it is decoupled from the core, and how easily it can be upgraded or maintained. Level A is extend with SAP build, either side-by-side or on-stack. Level B is leverage classic APIs. Level C, accessing the internal objects. And level D, not recommended of extensions. So by distinguishing between these levels, it enables businesses to make informed development decisions, prioritize the high risk extensions, and ensure it's compliant with Clean Code principle. It supports transparent decision making regarding where to invest in cleanup, modernization, or new development. I will leave the link of the Extensibility Guide, Clean Code Extensibility White Paper, and the blog post in the description. Check it out.
As you may have seen already in the release notes section of CAPIA, the official CAP documentation, the July 2025 release of CAP is out. All the details from this release can be found on the relevant release notes page, but let me give you the highlights. First, there are a couple of items in the general category. You can now provide custom validation messages when you use any of the assert range, assert format, or mandatory annotations in your CDS model. And of course, using internationalization bundles, you can provide language-specific variants for those custom messages. We've seen the growth and maturing of CAP's support for Fiori tree views over the recent months. And with this July release, that support is now GA. Generally available, with lots of features out of the box and more to come. Now, in the Node.js category, there's improved reference documentation for the subject property of a request object. And if you're wondering what that is, it's a query in CQN. And if you want to learn more about this fundamental building block of CAP, check out the Art and Science of CAP series with me and Daniel Hudson. If you're migrating from XSUAA to IAS, you'll be happy to know that CAP's IAS strategy automatically supports XSUAA tokens, as long as you have the necessary bindings in place, of course. That means you can configure your requirements like this for a win-win. Also, work on signature and token decode caches has also been carried out in relation to configuration of token caching with the SAP XSSec package. And last but certainly not least in this Node.js category, if you provide numeric values in your CSV files, they are now honored as such, as opposed to strings. If you do want them as strings, just prefix them with zeros, or of course, just enclose them in quotes. Now, in the Java category, you can now get the framework to do even more for you, even more work in the area of generic exception handling for empty results.single queries. This means less boilerplates, less code for you to write and maintain, following one of CAP's enduring philosophical drivers. And talking of writing less code and streamlining the code that you do write, the Draft Service API is now simpler, meaning you can update and delete draft-enabled entities in a more uniform way, bringing it more in line with how you manage non-draft-enabled entities. Finally, in the Java category, there are now improvements in how expand restrictions are checked by the runtime. This can be enabled in configuration, and with the annotations, you can control expands generally and expansion levels in particular. And there are updates in the tools category too. There's a new facet available in the CDS add command. That facet is GHA. So with CDS add GHA, you can quickly set up a GitHub Actions workflow for deployment, for example, to Cloud Foundry. And in the area of, in my opinion, amazing and already well-accomplished language support mechanisms for CAM. In the form of the language server and related facilities, there are new formatting options providing fine-grained control over space surrounding codons. And also, an experimental addition to the language server offerings in the form of GoTo implementations. Check it out in VS Code, of course, or if you're that way inclined, like me, in NeoVim, where it works too, especially via the LSP integration configuration in 0.11. Happy capping.
Today, we have an exciting update for partners working with SAP BTP ABAP environment or Steamfunk. Nora Clem, in her latest blog post, explains the new software delivery option called Add-on Product. So partners now have two ways to deliver solutions to customers. First is as a multi-tenant SaaS solution or service offering where partners fully manage development, production, and operations, and customers can adapt it using key user extensibility. Second is a new option as a software offering called add-on product, which is ideal for customers who want to run the solution in their own environment or need developer extensibility. It is delivered via the SAP store, installed and operated by the customers. Partners can use a hybrid delivery model, SaaS plus add-on, but delivering add-on products requires the SAP Partner Edge build track, which also provides rich resources, tools, and training. Add-on products follow the same initial build process as SaaS solutions, but require registration in Solution Hub, PE build contract, and optional certification for quality assurance. Customers must complete a one-time amendment process depending on contract date before add-on products can be installed and managed via the Landscape portal. The links for more technical information about the add-on product and SAP Partner Portal and the blog post are available in the description box below to check it out. Hey, I'm not gone yet. Gen AI-driven Extensibility Assistant is now live. It can answer questions related to field extensibility and field logic. It can assist you in various tasks related to field extensibility, including creating custom fields, finding business context for extending ads, services, APIs, or transactions. And you can also find the usage where the custom fields are used, finding value helps, and finding bodies. Check out the details in the help document, which I will leave in the description.
Hello, developers. There's some good news for ABAP developers. Users who have been using ABAP development tools for a while can now participate in a new survey which is available, and they can provide their valuable feedback. Those could be on the in the area of usability issues or the areas where the tool needs improvement. And you could also suggest what you would like to see in the tool in future. So, this will be a very valuable information for the ADT developers, and they would be more than happy to receive direct feedback from you. But this would also drive the future roadmap of the tool. So I encourage you to head over to the survey and provide your valuable feedback. The link to the survey will be provided in the description below.